الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. One of the important points in our religion, Islam, in عقيدة, the scholars discuss this point in عقيدة books. The companions, رضي الله تعالى عنهم, the companions of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, because they are the connection between us and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the enemies of Islam try to destroy this barrier or this connection by accusing the companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. And they try to choose some of them because they think there is a way to attack or to accuse this companion. And one of them is Uthman ibn Affan, radiyallahu ta'ala an. They accuse, and unfortunately some of the Muslims, some of the authors, they write something about Uthman, something bad about Uthman, radiyallahu ta'ala an. And you find a lot of Muslims follow these authors without knowledge. So I like to focus on the virtues of Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala, because this is part of our religion, to know the virtues of Uthman, Abu Bakr, Umar. This is part of our religion. You have to know this. Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala, he's one of the first companions who accepted Islam. He accepted Islam through Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala, and the first man who embraced Islam, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. And he called to Islam Abu Ubaid ibn al-Jarrah and Abdurrahman al-Awf, and one of them, Uthman ibn Affan. So he was one of the first people who accepted Islam. Uthman ibn Affan is the husband of the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Ruqayya. And after the death of Ruqayya, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave him another daughter, Kulthum. So he married two of the daughters of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when you think that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam trusted him to give him two of his daughters, so no doubt he was a trust man radiyallahu ta'ala an. Uthman ibn Affan, one of the 10 companions mentioned in a hadith that they will be in the paradise. So no need to criticize him. He in the paradise. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned a hadith, authentic hadith in Tirmidhi, Abu Bakr fil Jannah, Umar fil Jannah, Uthman fil Jannah, Ali fil Jannah, Abu Ubaidah Amr al Jarrah fil Jannah, Abdurrahman al Awf, Zubair al Awam, Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, Sa'id ibn Zayd, Zubair al Awam. All of these 10 companions in the paradise. So you criticize them or not, you praise them or not, this will not affect them. They will be in the paradise, no doubt. Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala an. Abdullah ibn Umar said, we used to compare at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who is the best companion? So we used to say Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr. And I gave a khutbah about Abu Bakr radiyallahu ta'ala an. Then Umar, the first man in the ummah, Abu Bakr. The second man, of course, after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the second man is Umar ibn al-Khattab. The third man is Uthman. Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala an. He is the third man of the Muslim ummah. He said, we were to say this, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was hearing this and he did not deny. He did not reject. It means he approved that Abu Bakr, then Umar, then Uthman, the best three persons in the Muslim Ummah. After the after Umar radiallahu ta'ala an, or before the death of Umar, when Abu Lu'lu' al-Majusi killed Umar radiallahu ta'ala an, so before the death of Umar, he said the Khilafah, the leader, should be one of the six people. He chose six people after him. And you choose one of them as a leader of the Muslim Ummah. Uthman al-Affan, Ali ibn Abi Talib, Abdurrahman al-Awf, Zubayn al-Awwam, Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, Zubayn al-Awwam, Abdurrahman al-Awf. Six of the companions, and all of them from the 10 people who will be in the paradise. At the end, all of them agreed that Uthman is the best and he should be the Khalifa. He should be the leader of the Muslim Ummah. All the companions. Abdurrahman al-Awf said, I went through all the houses of Medina and all of them agreed that Uthman is better than Ali. He should be the leader. Radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een. And some of the hadith about Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was lying and on a bed, and some of his thigh, part of his thigh, was exposed. Abu Bakr came. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not change his position. Then Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu came, and also he did not change his position sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Prophet when Uthman ibn Affan entered, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam changed his position and he covered his thigh. Aisha noticed this. O Rasulullah, when Abu Bakr, my father, when Umar entered, you did not change your position. But when Uthman ibn Affan came and you changed your position and you covered your thigh sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, should I not show modesty to one whom even the angels show modesty? Al-Haya. Radiyallahu ta'ala. And because he is a person who's feeling shy, he very, radiyallahu ta'ala, he feels shy to ask the Prophet ﷺ in this position, as some scholars mention. تَسْتَحِي مِنْهُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, even the angels show modesty for Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. There is a battle called Ghazwat Tabuk, a place called Tabuk. From Medina to Tabuk, many kilos, maybe 500, 1000 kilos. It was difficult, far, strong enemy. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked the companions to give charity, to support the army. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever will buy and dig the well of Ruma will be granted the paradise. Of course they need water. And they mentioned this well, which is called Ruma, was owned by a Jewish man. So people need, the Muslims need to pay to drink from this water. So Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala an bought this Ruma well. He said, and I bought and dug it. Don't you know that, he said, whoever equipped the army of al-Usra will be granted paradise? Also, another thing. He said, who can buy the well of Ruma, he will be granted paradise. Uthman bought this well and he dug this well. Also, who can prepare this army? Uthman radiallahu ta'ala, and again, he prepared this army. So he got two guarantees from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from this hadith only. Also another hadith, there are many hadith talk about Uthman that he will be in the paradise. People should know that when you talk and or when you read about Uthman, when you find someone who's nothing criticizing Uthman radiallahu ta'ala, and you should know that Uthman in the paradise radiallahu ta'ala, and not from one hadith. We are doubtful about this hadith authentic or not. There are plenty of hadith We are sure that Uthman radiallahu anh in the paradise, no doubt. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this hadith also authentic in Sahih Muslim, he was inside a garden and Abu Musa al-Ash'ari was the guardian on the gate. So anyone wants to enter, he should take permission. So Abu Bakr came, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari said, wait. He went inside, he told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he told him that Abu Bakr wants to enter. Can I give him the permission? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, yes. Tell Abu Bakr to enter and tell him you will be in the paradise. Give him glad tidings that you are in the paradise, Abu Bakr. Then the same Umar radiallahu ta'ala an. Then the same Uthman. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam added something for Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an. He said to Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, open the gate for Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an and give him glad tidings of entering paradise, and also inform him that you will enter the paradise ala balwa tusibuhu. Ala balwa tusibuhu. There will be a calamity for you. There will be a trial before your death. And subhanAllah, this happened. As you know, that when the Khariji came to Medina and they killed Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an inside his house, and they prevent him, they stopped him not to pray in the masjid and not to drink from the bi'r rumah. And he told them, I bought this well, rumah, and now you stop me from drinking from this well. I pay the money to extend the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and now you stop me to pray in this part. Subhanallah. This is the Khawarij. This is the fitna. They don't know who are you. That's why they are killing the Muslim ummah. They killed the best companions at that time, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. Aqulu qawli hadha, astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu al-ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وأصحابه أما بعد. Also, one day Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه brought 1,000 دينار. The دينار, if you read the ahadith or the old books of fiqh, دينار means an amount of gold. It equals about 4 grams. So Uthman brought 1,000 dinar. 1,000 dinar. So it means more than 4,000 grams of gold. More than 40,000 KD. He brought this amount of money to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to prepare the army of the Muslims before one of the battles. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started to check this money. Then he said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whatever Uthman does after today will not harm him. Whatever Uthman does after today will not harm him. He repeated this twice. He means this charity will guarantee for him the paradise. For sure, everything is forgiven for him. Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala an. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was on a mountain called Thabir. In Mecca, there is a mountain called Thabir. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr, Umar, and Uthman. The greatest 4 people at that time. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman. The mountain started to shake. Some stones came down from this mountain. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kicked the mountain by his leg. Then he said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, be still, Thabir. Be still, Thabir. Don't move. فإنما عليك نبي وصديق وشهيدان. فإنما عليك نبي وصديق وشهيدان. Four people. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to this mountain, he was talking to the mountain, be still Thabir, for upon you are a prophet, Siddiq means Abu Bakr Siddiq, and two martyrs, two shaheed. Umar was killed as a shaheed by Abu Lu'lu al-Majusi. Uthman was killed by the Khawarij. So this is the third Khalifa, Uthman ibn Affan. So be careful. If you read anything bad about Uthman ibn Affan, you should reject. Don't accept anything bad about our companions, the great companions, the four Khalifa, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, radiallahu ta'ala anhum. And if you see that they are accusing them, it means they are accusing Islam. Because what is the meaning that they accuse the companions? They are accusing our religion, our Quran and Sunnah. Uthman was one of the people who were writing the Wahi. He was writing the Quran for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. How we are reading now the Quran? The same Quran everywhere in the East and West, in the Arab and the non-Arab world. Because of Uthman, one of them, Uthman, Muawiyah, Ali, Ubay ibn Ka'b, they wrote the Quran for us. They protected the Quran for us. So accusing them, it means accusing the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين يا رب من أرادنا والإسلام المسلمين بسوء فرد كيده في نحره فرد كيده في نحل يا رب العالمين واجعل الدائرة علي أرينا في أعداء الدين عجائب قدرتك يا رب العالمين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.
قد قامت الصلاة